everyone. Welcome to the REALab. I'm Shuran Song. So we are now standing in this brand new robotic center at Stanford. So in our lab, we are trying to make robots more capable and useful so that one day you can have one of them in your home to help you to do your laundries or clean your dishes. So we are trying really hard to work on that. And in many of our methods, we're trying to make use of machine learning and make robots to learn those useful skills directly from data. But the tricky part is always about how to get those robot data for learning, which is something that you cannot just directly download from the internet. So today, some of my students will show you around the lab and tell you a little bit about their approach to this problem. So come on in.
Human demonstration is the most intuitive way to teach robots. However, collecting manipulation data that can actually lead to deployable policy has been traditionally difficult. I'm Cheng.
I'm Linjia.
I'm Chuar.
We develop universal manipulation interface, a low-cost portable device that allows large-scale in-the-wild demonstration data collection.
We can teach robots to autonomously wash dishes, toss objects, fold clothes, all with just a few hours of data demonstration.
To enable these unprecedented capabilities, we developed diffusion policy, an end-to-end learning framework that captures complex, multimodal human actions.
Hi, Amanda. Beyond single skill policy, we develop XQ, which automatically discovers reusable skills such as grasping clothes and open the microwave, and compose them together to complete non-horizontal tasks.
Behavior cloning is great for tasks that humans are good at, but what about ones that humans aren't good at, such as walking on four legs? In this case, we need a different way to collect robot experiences, such as through the usage of simulators.
I'm Huy, and this is Huy, and we're working together to teach robot dogs how to use their entire bodies for manipulation tasks, such as grasping, tossing, and pulling.
To tackle this problem, we're training a full-body controller inside the simulator through very cheap trial and error, so that the dog gradually learns how to balance, walk, and reach. We transfer the learned knowledge from the simulator to the real-world robots, and finally, the whole-body controller can handle all the movements given only the ineffective trajectories. This allows the dog body to be included in complex manipulation tasks.
We've seen incredible progress in robots performing different tasks such as shakes and embodiment. But can we generate different robot mechanism designs to adapt to new tasks and environments? I'm Xiaomeng, and in our recent work, Dynamics Guided Diffusion Model for Robot Manipulator Design, we proposed a data-driven framework for generating manipulator geometry designs for given manipulation tasks. Our generated manipulators robustly perform drastically different tasks with only an open loop, parallel draw flows in motion, and no perception. The best part is, we generate all of these designs for different objects and different tasks with the same model.
Hi, my name is Austin, and with the recent advancements in generative robot design, there's an increasing need for robot policies that can generalize across a range of different embodiments. Consider this robot hand. It's a multi-fingered robot hand that has different joints and fingers that can be added or removed. And right now, we have to train a separate policy for each of these different configurations. This is costly and expensive, and oftentimes really redundant. I'm creating a new robot policy that can condition on the current hardware configuration of the robot in order to control it, regardless of whether fingers are added or removed. With this new policy, we're able to have a shared behavior model that can control many different configurations of the hand and even generalize to a brand new embodiment that it hasn't seen before, all while training completely in simulation.
Now, simulators are great when they're an accurate reflection of the real world, but in some cases, that might still be challenging. For instance, simulating cloths accurately is still very challenging. In those cases, we might want a robot to automatically collect its own experiences directly in the real world. We've explored this in Flingbot, a system that automatically learns to unfold cloths by itself. By giving it a top-down camera to track unfolding progress and a mechanism for resetting the cloth after a few unfolding attempts, the system learns by itself. This means I would start the unlearning process, go home and sleep, and in the morning I'd wake up to a system that has learned to unfold clocks.
FlingBot is one example where two robot agents have to work together to complete a task. In the real world, many scenarios require robots to collaborate with the other agents and achieve more semantically complex tasks. My name is Mandy. In our recent work, Rocco, we study how to use pre-trained large language models to facilitate such collaborations. We propose a new framework where different agents can discuss task strategies using large language models. We show that this framework can achieve a variety of multi-robot manipulation tasks, and we can have a robot talking with a human in real time to complete the task together.
Even though our robots become more capable of handling complex and long-horizon tasks, they still fail a lot of times. My name is De Yi. In our recent work, Reflect, we gave our robot self-reflection ability to automatically identify and explain its failures. The failure explanation is either useful for a human to debug the failure or the robot to generate a correction plan. To do so, our framework converts multi-sensory observations such as RGBD images and audio into a textual summary of the robot past experiences, which can then be analyzed by a large language model for failure explanation given its common sense reasoning abilities. With all the efforts in the real lab, we hope to give our robots better perception, reasoning, and planning abilities, and eventually bring generalist robots to your home and workspace.